Hey, it's Tim here. In 23.2, you can now calculate the length of a line or a multi-line geometry easily inside a Tableau, meaning you don't have to blend in lengths and distances anymore. You can calculate them as long as you have the spatial object available in Tableau. To find out how, let's get stuck in. Okay, so here we have water bodies in London. This is a very basic data set. I've used it in the past, and I think it's just a nice way of showing this feature. If I right click on geometry and I go ahead and create a new calculated field, you can see that I've already got the length function here set up. So all you need to do is give it the spatial object and the units. Of course, it only works with line and multi-line string. It'd be interesting to see if you create the outline of an object, if it can actually calculate the distance around that. So we're going to try that as well, because the outline function is a new object in this particular release. So let's go ahead and do this. Let's go ahead and calculate length. And you can see here that we get the function put in, and all we need to do is add a comma and then do two speech marks and then put in MI, feet. You can do kilometers, miles, whatever units you type in is what it will apply. You can see in the example they've got feet. So let's go ahead and call this length and spell that correctly. And then after we've done that, hit apply. And there we go. We have the function. That's pretty much it. It's dead simple. We can actually drag the length onto the label just to see that it's working nicely. We should see the lengths pop up. And don't forget, these are in miles. So we can already see these working nicely. Now, what's the use case for this? Well, actually, it's for being analytical, frankly. if you've got these water body names and you know you have the relevant geometries in your data set, what you can actually do is skip the geometry, calculate the length with the geometry, but then just use the length for whatever type of analysis you're trying to do. So if I want to know which is the longest water body in London, it's the Grand Union Canal, and I can tell you that it's 23.88 miles. Now, of course, this is only going to be as accurate as the geometry, and geometries are super interesting because the more accurate they are, the larger the file type tends to be. Let's say you're trying to do the geometry of the outline of the United Kingdom. If you do that accurate to as much detail as you possibly can, that's probably going to be a dataset too big for putting inside of something like Tableau. So there is a little bit of generalization that goes on, and so you have to bear that in mind with spatial objects. But nonetheless, it should be okay as an approximation and something you can use. Another use case is if you've got spatial objects, let's say GPS traces, you can bring those into Tableau and you can start analyzing different routes taken by certain modes of transport. Maybe you work for a delivery or distribution company and you do track the routes that your vans are taking. You could try and optimize a little bit on those routes by seeing which ones are, you know, performing the best, but you could also use things like travel time against that to kind of try and find where the sweet spot is. Another use case is you could use this to do all sorts of calculations to do with the impact on the environment. For example, if you're traveling further, are you using more fuel, and therefore are you causing more of a CO2 issue in terms of the way your CO2 emissions are calculated? So these are all particular use cases that I think you can start to use this for that are actually quite relevant in the current climate, but also quite useful. Now, I also did say that we can potentially find the distance or the length of an outline of a outline created from a polygon inside of a new geometry. So let's go ahead, and I'm going to open up an old viz that I've already created that's actually already available on Tableau Public. We're going to see if that works. Let's switch over to that now. Okay, so here I am looking at the previous video I made on the outline function. You can see I already have all these outlines. What I want to do is take this outline and see if I can wrap it in the length function to calculate the distance around the boundary. That's sort of an interesting calculation we can do. So let's go ahead and create a calculation using the outline of the wards. And all we're going to do is we're going to go ahead and use the length function. So let's go ahead and search for it this way. And we'll just double click the length. And it will ask us, okay, how do you want to do that? And again, we'll do it in, let's do it this time in kilometers, just to show something different. And we'll say outline length in kilometers. And let's go ahead and do this. And boom, and hit apply. That seemed to work, no complaints there. And so we can go ahead to the different names, okay, and we can see which boundary has the largest outline. That's quite nice. It worked. That is pretty cool. So we could sort this out, and we can see here that Darwin actually has the biggest sort of outline. That doesn't mean it's got the largest area or anything. It just means it's got the largest outline. And there are some other ones here. For example, Village just looks like it's been sort of cut short. I don't think if it's it's kind of strange. I don't know if that's. Let's do this. Let's just put the polygon ID inside of this. And yeah, you can see this one's actually a combination of multiple polygons. So if you put the polygon ID, what it does is some of these areas are sometimes multi-polygons coming together. And so actually when you break it down like that, it's actually a lot smaller. So you can see that this is working a lot better, and you can see all of the different ones. So it's kind of something to be aware of when you're doing this. You have to really think through sort of what you're trying to do and make sure it works. But in real terms, it is actually able to, let's say, take, if you just got a single polygon, let's take for example Elm Park or Chrome, all of these ones here, they just have a single polygon making up that specific ward. So then you're able to go and figure out the distance of the outline. So you can do that very easy. I don't know what kind of use that might be. Maybe you're trying to figure out how much fencing you need to put up around a specific area, or you're trying to visualize, you know, how many miles of coverage you're going to have to put to cover a boundary. This is a really nice way of doing it really quickly inside of Tableau, because again, you can get a rough estimate and you can start to work with really large distances, but give yourself a good sort of leeway for that. But remember, the accuracy can be hit and miss depending on how detailed those polygons are in the first place. Okay, that's pretty much it. Thanks for watching this video, and I'll catch you in the next one.